What's up, guys? Shane Larson here. This is the Game Time Grind. We're reintroducing this new version, this new segment of my platform after like 5 years of a hiatus. So today we're going to be talking about Meridian High School basketball. So tune in. Yo, so my name is Shane Larson. I am the host of the Game Time Guru podcast. This is the Game Time Grind. The difference is the Game Time Guru is my platform for my podcast where I interview other sports figures across the globe. And the Game Time Grind is where I'm going to actually be sharing my thoughts and my feelings with you guys regarding the different sports topics. So I used to do this back in like 2017-18 timeframe. I haven't done it for a long time, but I just want to be able to have a platform to share with you guys. Now, my biggest initiative in 2024 is to get the YouTube side of things kind of cranking up a little bit. I never really made YouTube a focus, and I probably should. I post all of my interviews on there. All my stuff is on this platform, but I've never really optimized it, right? And so I'm trying to make it a little bit more of a focus for me, and this will be just part of that. So the Game Time Grind will be solely on YouTube if you guys want to catch it and check it out. So with that being said, the audio side of my podcast is where it's well established. I have a listener base all across the world. 182 countries have downloaded the podcast. All 50 states have listeners at some point who have listened to the podcast. But now we're trying to get both to start rolling. So if you're watching this on YouTube, please make sure to hit that subscribe button. Help me out. And yeah, it'll be quick little segments like this. Now, I do have a full-time job, which is pretty extensive, to be honest. So you're not going to see me doing this every single day. I'll probably record these on the weekends and try to get some different segments out here to talk with you guys. But I love to interact with you guys. If I have time in the evenings, obviously outside of my work hours, I'll be recording this so that I can share it with you guys and interact with you guys here on the platform. So I told you guys I wanted to talk about Meridian High School basketball here in Idaho. That's where I'm from. I went to Meridian High School, class of 2006. And the other day, I was at a Meridian High School basketball game. It was the senior night, last game of the season for them. And one of the things that just stood out to me, it stood out to me for a while on my podcast, just a few years back, I think it was almost 4 or 5 years ago now, I had Coach Jeff Sainer join my podcast. He's the head coach at Meridian High School because he took them back to state that year. It was the year before the world locked down from COVID. And so he took them back to the state tournament, and that was the first time they'd been back to state since my senior year in high school. So it was like a 14-year hiatus, right? And so it was a pretty big deal. So I actually interviewed him on my show to talk about the culture change. And then from that time forward, Jeff, who I didn't know anything about until my podcast, actually was super cool and proactively reached out and helped me get in contact with some of the players that were playing for his program, like Drayson Fisher, who I love, McKay Anderson, Brody Roberry, Donovan Sainer, Jeff's son. We spoke with those guys on the podcast, and it was, you know, with his permission. And I just always respected Jeff from that. Now, since that time, you know, I coach basketball at the club level, and I know a lot of the coaches around the Valley because for a few years I was running a business with some business partners with high school media. So I got to be around a lot of the coaches, and I've just gained an immense amount of respect for Jeff. I really respect Jeff and what he's done, but because I'm a Warrior, you know, Meridian High School alum, this one just kind of sits a little bit different with me because I have my bias towards that school. I've always been open about that. I love the Warriors. I love everybody else around here too. I love the kids that I've coached. I love everybody from different schools. Don't get it twisted, but I do have a massive respect of what's going on over at Meridian High because that's my school. Okay. So we go over there, Meridian High School, senior night. The way they honored their seniors first and foremost was amazing. It actually really, like, this is what put me into like this thought process the last couple of days, because the way they honored them with a video, the way in which they just had everybody lined up at the beginning of the game to do the whole ceremony, the whole thing. And then all the kids were friends. A lot of them were friends from years and years back. And it reminded me of when I was a senior, and a lot of our kids, like fifth, sixth grade, we're all friends. And we always talked about our senior year in high school, which seemed like a, you know, lifetime away. We're gonna be so good our senior year. We all progressed at different levels. Some were on varsity as, you know, sophomores. Some, like myself, didn't make varsity till my senior year. But we all progressed at different levels. And then when we finally were there, we had a really cool season, you know. and we made it to the state tournament. We won the consolation. Like, we were pretty happy about it. You know, it wasn't what we ultimately wanted, but we had a pretty good year. And senior night that year was kind of the same thing. We were all friends, and it was kind of sad, right? Like, you're like, man, we did it. And then everyone kind of branches off after high school. And I started thinking about that. Like, that's how the program was. Like, they have, everybody's like celebrating, but not just the seniors, right? They're underclassmen too. Like, they're guys that are on the team were celebrating those seniors too. Like, they were a big family. There's a huge family culture at that program. Okay. And that has to do with the culture, dude. There's a culture shift there. Not every program around here has that bond. There's some great basketball programs around here. Don't get it twisted. Like, there's some great basketball programs, but not all, even some of those great basketball programs don't have the family bond, right? They don't, they're just really good basketball players, right? But what I noticed about Meridian was that this family bond that they have, they're true friends, you know, and they've grinded out the practices together, and they've gone through it all together in practices and put everything on the line. And, you know, it's a complete culture shift, right? I don't understand. I don't think people understand. Like, if you were at the game and you're like, man, this is awesome. This is kind of the standard of Meridian High School basketball. Like, you know, finish in the top three or four in the conference and, you know, go compete for districts and try to get into state and compete for a championship. That's not what the standard was, though, before Jeff Sainer got there. That's not. It's not what it was. In fact, that program, with all due respect to the previous coaches and players that have come through that program, they all know what I'm talking about. The program was in shambles, dude. And I don't know how else to say it. Like, it wasn't a good program. It wasn't a good culture. It wasn't a winning culture. I mean, it's not like there wasn't great athletes. There were some great athletes that came through that program from the time I graduated till the time that they made it back to state 14 years later. But, like, the program itself was not a winning program. Okay. So that's just the facts. And I don't know if people realize that. Like, sometimes I'm like, man, I wonder if these kids even realize what they got, like, here. Like, this is insane. Because when I came home from my 2-year church mission in 2010 is when I returned home. Dude, all we heard about was how bad Meridian High School basketball had gotten and how bad their football program had gotten. And I'm like, what happened? But then they would talk about, you know, like, the new schools that came down. You know, there's a new school that was built just a couple of miles down the road on the same street, you know, and you get kind of landlocked. Now, I think since then there have been some changes in some things to help, like, if you want to get kids, like, if kids want to go to a certain school and stuff. But, like, when you're landlocked as a public school, it's kind of hard, especially in certain geographical situations, right? So you don't have a ton of athletes, and the income's different, the access to different things and the facilities are different. And Meridian wasn't really a school that was like, it was like the old school. It was the older school. Like, the flashy new schools were popping up. And so it wasn't a school that, like, people really wanted to go to. And I don't blame the kids, you know, it's hard. But now it's like, people want to go there because Coach Sainer has changed the culture. It's one thing to say that you're going to come in there and change the culture. It's another thing to get it to actually happen, right? You watch a Coach Carter. This is what I talked about when Coach Sainer spoke to me on my podcast. It's like a modern day Coach Carter, because you come in there and you're going to change the culture. So you're going to disrupt. It's a pattern interrupt. You're going to disrupt what's currently being taught there. And some players are not going to like that. And some parents are not going to like that. And it's hard to get everyone to buy in. And you're not always going to get, you're not going to please everybody. And so that's why it's hard. And then sometimes if you try to come and change a culture, and then you're 2 or 3 years into the mix and it's still not working and people are frustrated and the athletic directors are dealing with the pressures of boosters and all the stuff, the political side of it, they don't have a lot of time. They don't have a long leash, so to speak. But, you know, Sainer's been able to do it. And it's really cool to watch. It's really cool to watch. Like, the standard has been set. There's a shift in mentality there. Like, you can tell, like, people want to go to the games. The students want to go to the games. They're going to be there. And it felt like, coming full circle, like, that's how it was when we were seniors. We weren't the best team in the state by any means. We were, you know, middle of the pack of the conference, usually in the top 4 or 5. But, like, you know, our conference was pretty talented. But we were always competing, and we had people at the games, and it was fun. You know, we did our thing. And then it just kind of died off for like 14 years. And you always kind of thought, like, oh man, there's no hope left. And what he's been able to do there has been astonishing. It's been quite literally astonishing. It's incredible. So it was awesome to watch and just kind of take it all in and be like, man, he really has changed things here. And my last piece that I'll say here is that can happen at any school. I think what he does well is he has, you know, there's proof. He's got a track record of like being able to use the talent that he has and get the most out of it. Like if he gets the talent, he knows, he figures out the strengths and weaknesses and he figures it out, and the coaching staff that he has buys in, and everybody buys in. They all fight together. And that's why it's like a family bond, because those kids, they probably have some rigorous practices, man. I'm sure that they've gone through it with those, but he's figured out a way to make it happen. And it's just awesome to watch. So for me as a Meridian alum, really cool to see where the program is at. And I look forward to seeing it continue to build, you know, and I just want people to remember it wasn't always that way. It was in shambles. And now the standard has been changed. Thanks, guys.